مساء الخير. احنا النهاردة بنبتدي second day of advanced course in heart failure. بنرحب بالحضور. هنبتدي بhot debates. عندنا two hot debates. ال first debate هي cardiac resynchronization therapy. We should wait for the effect of sacubitril valsartan, sodium glucose transport to inhibitors, and rehabilitation before implanting a CRT. البرو هيبقى دكتور محمد صنهوري مدرس أمراض القلب في كلية الطب جامعة اسكندرية. أما الكونترا فهو دكتور مصطفى داود مدرس مساعد ودكتور معتز زكي عنده ظروف فكتر خيره دكتور مصطفى داود إن هو he is replacing him. فهنستمع الأول لدكتور محمد صنهوري that we should wait for the effect of sacubitril/valsartan, sodium glucose transport inhibitors, and rehabilitation before implanting.
شكرا دكتور محمود على الانترودكشن. My pleasure to be with you today presenting my debate about should we wait for the effect of the new drugs for heart failure like ARNI and SGLT2 inhibitors before implanting the CRT or ICD or not. As you know, some of our colleagues push the patient from the beginning to the device-based therapy for CRT or ICD, despite the fact that not all patients will be responder to either of both devices. And all of us know the new guidelines recommend trial of optimal medical treatment before taking the decision to implant the device. HFrEF patients are very poor patients actually, despite the recent advances in the clinical management and the medical therapy, and the mortality remains high. And the goal of treatment is to improve the symptoms, survival, and the lifestyle sure of the patient. During the first decade of the 20th century, CRT and CRTD and ICD are the mainstay of treatment, while during the second decade, with introduction of ARNI and the SGLT2 inhibitors into the clinical practice, we can revise ourselves regarding the decision to refer the patient for CRT or ICD, and we should exhaust ourselves in the medical treatment, especially with the new drugs. The guidelines recommend ICD for secondary prevention of sudden cardiac death in patients with hemodynamically significant ventricular arrhythmia or resuscitated sudden cardiac death, as we all know. And for primary prevention, we may refer the patient for ICD if the patient has NEHA 2 to 3 symptoms, with ejection fraction remains less than 35%, despite a trial of 3 months of optimal medical treatment, whether the underlying etiology is ischemia or dilated cardiomyopathy. For CRT, the guidelines recommend referring the patient for CRT if he has resistant heart failure symptoms, despite optimal medical treatment for more than 3 months, with the QRS duration more than 130 milliseconds, preferably to be in left bundle branch block morphology. This is the highest level of evidence according to the landmark trial, the CARE Heart Failure Companion and Domestic Trial. But all the above mentioned the trials are conducted between 2000-2010, when ARNI and SGLT2 inhibitors are not popular in the clinical practice. As you know, ICD prevents about 50-60% of sudden cardiac death cases, not all the cases, and the CRT is indicated in selected patient population with heart failure who have white QRS complex, who have left bundle morphology. And as you know, 30% of patients with HFrEF will have left bundle branch block morphology, which means that 2/3 of heart failure patients with reduced ejection fraction have no left bundle branch block morphology, so they may not be a good candidate for device-based therapy. In addition to the patient with narrow QRS complex, the patient with non-left bundle branch block morphology. If we review the guidelines of device implantation or device-based therapy, we will find this fixed sentence. The patient should have ejection fraction less than 35% despite at least 3 months treatment with optimal medical therapy. But what is the optimal medical therapy? And about 10 years ago, the optimal medical therapy includes ACE or ARB, beta blockers, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonists. These drugs have well-established role in preventing the total cardiovascular death and heart failure hospitalization. But after introduction of sacubitril valsartan into the clinical practice, it gives us more than 20% higher reduction in the mortality compared to ACE or ARBs. The heart failure guidelines just released couple of days ago. It recommend to initiate in all patients with HFrEF ACE inhibitors as the first step to reduce the heart failure hospitalization and death, and preferably to initiate ARNI in favor of ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist, and the SGLT2 inhibitors, dabigliflozin and empagliflozin, in those patients in order to reduce the heart failure hospitalization and death. This is the mainstay of treatment, and this is the optimal medical therapy according to the guidelines. And if we could initiate the four drugs together, this will be very good for the patient. So this interesting analysis includes three landmark large trials, the emphasis heart failure, the paradigm heart failure, and the TABA heart failure patients. And it compared what we call the comprehensive medical approach, which includes ARNI, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist, and SGLT2 inhibitors, versus the conventional therapy of ACE or ARB and beta blocker and mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist, and it found superior efficacy of the comprehensive medical approach versus the conventional medical approach in reducing the cardiovascular mortality and hospitalization. The paradigm heart failure proved that sacubitril valsartan combination is superior to enalapril twice daily in reducing the cardiovascular death and hospitalization in heart failure patient, and that's why sacubitril valsartan combination is recommended according to the guidelines. The DABA heart failure proved that dabigliflozin 10 milligram daily versus placebo improved the composite endpoint of cardiovascular death and heart failure hospitalization. The same was observed for the Imperial reduced trial, which approved the empagliflozin in the clinical practice versus placebo. It improved the mortality and the cardiovascular hospitalization in addition to the renal events. The renal events are improved in patients with randomized to empagliflozin versus the placebo. So, does ARNI affect the cardiac structure and function? It actually improves the symptoms, but it could, in the same time, improve the structure and the function of the heart, improving the ejection fraction. The answer is yes. According to this trial, sacubitril valsartan versus standard of care treatment in HFrEF patients improved both the clinical and the echocardiographic data. The clinical data improved in the form of improvement in the AGFR and reducing the need for loop diuresis. And concerning the echo parameters or the cardiac structure, the ejection fraction improved, the LV dimensions reduced and volumes, the systolic pulmonary artery pressure was reduced, and the diastolic function improved also after sacubitril valsartan versus the conventional standard of care. This, the same was observed in this Taiwanese trial, proving the same concept of reverse remodeling, what we call reverse remodeling, in the form of improving the left ventricular ejection fraction and the reduction in the left ventricular volume. The same was confirmed in this prospective trial, evaluating the effect of sacubitril valsartan on the echo parameters in HFrEF patients. And if you look here, the ejection fraction before starting the treatment was 32, and it improves after starting the treatment to 36 plus or minus 6. Which means that if we start those medications, the ejection fraction of the patient could actually improve and become more than 35%. At the same time, the patient may not be a candidate for any device-based treatment, because most of the guidelines recommend the device-based therapy on the ejection fraction less than 35%. The most significant side effect of ARNI is symptomatic hypotension. This is the most common side effect of ARNI, which necessitates in some patients drug discontinuation or reduction of the dose. And there are some concerns about beta amyloid protein deposition in the brain and the cases of Alzheimer's. This so far is studied in animal models and not in human. The SGLT2 inhibitors improve both the cardiovascular and renal outcome, which is not correlated with their blood glucose lowering effect, because their blood glucose lowering effect is much less than other anti or hypoglycemic agents. Despite that, it proved superior cardiovascular efficacy. At the level of the heart, SGLT2 inhibitors improve the energy metabolism and reduce the oxidative stress. At the level of the kidney, it induces natriuresis and diuresis. That's why SGLT2 inhibitors may reduce the need for lobe diuresis, for example. And at the level of vasculature, it reduces the vascular inflammation and the fibrosis. And at the whole body, it reduces the sympathetic nervous system activation, increased erythrobiotin. In this way, it could improve the overall outcome of heart failure patients. And that's why it's recommended in the guidelines as a class one, as a part of optimal medical treatment. In this trial, including more than 300 diabetic patients randomized to SGLT2 inhibitors, whether they have or not heart failure. And divide the patient into four groups, and it found that the use of SGLT2 inhibitors improves the LV geometry, systolic and diastolic function in type 2 diabetic patients. And the improvement was even more prominent in heart failure patients, namely in HFrEF, not in HFpEF, not in heart failure with preserved ejection fraction. So the highest level of recommendation is to use those drugs in patients with HFrEF in order to improve the cardiovascular mortality and hospitalization. Also, SGLT2 inhibitors have some anti-arrhythmic effect. In this trial, including about 400,000 patients, the use of SGLT2 inhibitors versus placebo reduces the incidence of new onset arrhythmia and improves the total cardiovascular outcome. So it could, for example, reduce the need for ICD. Both CRT and ARNI reduces the cardiac adverse cardiac remodeling, but no trial so far comparing both CRT with ARNI. ARNI also, like SGLT2 inhibitors, have anti-arrhythmic effect. In paradigm heart failure, there is a 22% reduction in the risk of sudden cardiac death with the use of sacubitril valsartan. Why? Because of the concept of cardiac reverse remodeling. It improves the dimensions of the left ventricle. It increases the ejection fraction, what we call the reverse remodeling. This could be translated into lower risk of arrhythmia due to reduction in the arrhythmic substrate. The SAFE ICD trial presented in the EHRA conference 2020, it includes 200 patients with HFrEF who were implanted with ICD or CRTD. And this trial found that patients, after initiating the sacubitril valsartan, about one quarter of the patients, or 25% of the patient, had ejection fraction more than 35% at 6 months of follow-up. So after 6 months of initiating the sacubitril valsartan, almost 1 in 4 patients will be no more a candidate for ICD or CRTD because his ejection fraction is more than 35%. This is the concept of reverse remodeling, the reverse remodeling. And the concept of reverse remodeling is closely correlated with the incidence of, or reduction of the incidence of ventricular arrhythmia. In this nice trial, with reverse remodeling initiated with, in the form of increase in the left ventricular ejection fraction after use of sacubitril valsartan, this increase in the ejection fraction by only 5% is translated into reduction in the BVC load in the 24-hour Holter, in the non-sustained DVT, and the most interesting point is reduction in the appropriate ICD therapy. The patients who were implanted with ICD after initiating this drug have less incidence of ventricular tachycardia and ventricular fibrillation and less need for ICD delivered therapy. This example from this trial, patient after starting with very large BVC load, after starting sacubitril valsartan, the BVC load starts to reduce until we maximize the dose of sacubitril valsartan. After that point, the incidence of VT or the prevalence of BVCs in this patient becomes negligible. This nice commentary just published in the Egyptian Heart Journal about Will's introduction of ARNI into clinical practice will reduce the need for device therapy in patients with HFrEF, and the authors here believe that ARNI and device therapy are two complementary therapies. And patients, and we should start in all patients with ARNI and SGLT2 inhibitors and postpone the use of CRT or ICD until at least 3 months. The concept of the Fantastic Four, as all of us know this interesting editorial, it recommends the use in all patients, like the last guidelines, the use of mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist, beta blockers, SGLT2 inhibitors, and ARNI should be used as an initial step in all patients with HFrEF. with the device therapy used in selected, in some selected patient who resist the medical treatment after at least 3 months of follow-up. So my final take-home message, ARNI and the SGLT2 inhibitors can be used in most symptomatic patients with HFrEF, but CRT and ICD could be used in certain selected patient population. With time and with improvement in the ejection fraction and with reverse remodeling, as I mentioned, this could reduce the need for ICD for primary prevention. For example, the patient may no more be candidate for ICD after improvement of his ejection fraction with these drugs. Also, those drugs will improve the percentage of biventricular pacing in a patient with CRT by reducing the ventricular ectopy and the ventricular arrhythmia. And this could increase the responder rate after device implantation. And also, ARNI proved to reduce the appropriate ICD discharges by reducing the overall arrhythmic burden. We should follow the guidelines on appropriate use of ICD, CRT, and optimal medical treatment. We may use ARNI and SGLT2 inhibitors more frequently into clinical practice. The totality of evidence now suggests that patients with HFrEF should be treated with a combination of 4 drugs. Actually, as the patient tolerates, as the patient could tolerate, if the patient could tolerate the 4 drugs, we should initiate from the beginning ARNI, mineralocorticoid receptor antagonist, the beta blockers, and the SGLT2 inhibitors, and follow the patient for response for at least 3 months. And we assess what we call the reverse remodeling. If the ejection fraction was improved and dimensions reduced, so there will be no need for device implantation. And thank you.
Shukran, Dr. Sanhoury, for this very excellent presentation. Dr. Mustafa Dawood هيدخل يتكلم وبعد كده الريباتل بقى انتوا الاثنين هتطلعوا فوق واحنا اللي هنسألكم. بس الحقيقة يعني دكتور سنهوري يعني هو he's very wise. أنا ما أنساش مرة بعت له حالة heart failure with reduced ejection fraction, left bundle branch block, يعني typical for CRT. فهو قال لي بص يا بيه العيان on optimal medical treatment to asymptomatic. ما نسكت نصبر عليه شوية وفعلا يعني ف it's wise.